There's a red light. Through the English, so that's when. Then I, for meditation, then I chant. It can be similar tune, but it can be chanted in English as well. But now, at the moment I chant, but so what is the main thing? Is the meditation, meditate in each words. It's so important, the basis of the Buddha's teaching. Very, very important. To realize the conventional nature and the ultimate nature, and it's only disturbing thought. Delusion, to be able to overcome, to be able to defeat, to be able to cease, then it should be our ultimate happiness, liberation from oceans of samsara suffering. the everlasting happiness. And that, then also the with the support of a bodhicitta, you know, letting go, I cherishing numberless sentiments. More than scars of so it's merit, then able to actualize mind about it, able to cease with the ultimate wisdom, realizing emptiness, able to cease the subtle obscuration, then achieve, and then develop the ultimate wisdom, possessed with the bodhicitta, develop bodhicitta, develop bodhicitta, or the ultimate, develop ultimate, possessed by the bodhicitta. So, cooperatively, then achieve the true kai. Achieve the dharma kai, rupa kai, Buddha's holy body, holy mind, for the benefit of the numberless sentient beings, free from the oceans of samsara sufferings, and bring them to the peerless happiness, Buddhahood, so the total cessation of obscuration, completion of all the realizations. So as I explained yesterday, so I'm not going to repeat again. So, yeah, I'm interested. Try to, I use the word digest, like the food digest, you know, there's the subject of meditation, you know, to understand, to recognize, to actualize, you know, then you can overcome delusion. Then you can overcome your enemy. From beginningless rebirth, not only from this morning, not only from rebirth, this life, but from beginningless rebirth, that delusion, your enemy has defeated you, cheated you. You know, cause suffer you, torture you from beginningless rebirth now. So now you overcome, now you defeat the delusion back, you know. Conquer the delusion, cause of your enemy, the cause of suffering. You defeat now, you know, at this time. One time we received not only human rebirth, but perfect human rebirth during this time. So I met not only that, I met the Buddha Dharma, and then material mind teaching, then also the guide, revealing the unnecessary path to enlightenment. So during this time, it's the opportunity to defeat your enemy, delusion. Your enemy, your mind, which is creator of all your suffering. You know, that defeat that now, this time. Om Ro. Momento. Dedication.
Thank you.
One pointedly requesting to Guru Shakyamuni Buddha, the founder of the Dharma, kind compassion of Guru Shakyamuni Buddha, to purify all the wrong concepts. To Guru was up to the subtle rule view, they up to the last, obstacle to it, interfere to it, omniscience. So all that to purify with white light, and then replica. You receive, you become one with that. So it's all the realizations. After enlightenment, Dharmakaya, part of all the method of wisdom, from the root of part of enlightenment, Guru wisdom, all that, think that. Can you read the foundation good quality of the whole path to enlightenment in the essence? What we have to actualize. Not only to enlighten you, but to free the numberless sentient beings, each and every sentient being from the original samsara suffering, and bring to the peerless happiness full Buddhahood. For that, read that. So everyone meant it. Everyone, either read or meant it. Think in what she was saying. So whatever.
Seven,
So by studying this, it plants the seed of a whole path to enlightenment in our mental continuum. It plants the seed of the whole path to enlightenment. So without exercising the path, no way to achieve enlightenment. Just praying, enlightenment drops in your brain, you know like that. Enlightenment comes with rain, you know, snow or rain, none of that. Drop from the sky, no, none of that. So we have to actualize them through the correct listening, reflection, meditation practice. Then we actualize the whole path to enlightenment. The elaborate, what the Buddha said, what the Pandit said, the elaborate or middle essence, how we to actualize through meditation, listening, reflection, we actualize the path to enlightenment, that's the important, extremely important. So reciting mindfully, listen mindfully, or the reciting mindfully. What's that meaning? So the essence of the path to enlightenment. So without that, no way to reach realization, no way to develop the mind, no way. So cannot be free from. You don't actualize path, so there is no way to be free from samsara. Even that. Okay, so this the main solution. If you don't like suffering, this is what you have to do. This is the solution what you have to do. You know, no matter how much we put effort externally, to solve the problems, but the problems will come over. Even you to stop it, well, temporarily, and then not the root, but it comes again and again, even this life, in the other lifetimes. Even during this life, but other lifetimes. So on and on. So like that. So I'm going to put effort, excellence. Oh, this internally, so through the listening, reflection, meditation practice, teaching, then double the mind, through enlightenment. Oh, that's what we need, even up to the liberation from samsara, this is what we need to do. This is what we need to do if we don't like suffering. Yeah, if we're looking for liberation from samsara, then this, what has to do, what do we need to do? Even the rest of the world is looking outside to solve the problem, but the never ending. From beginning to the birth, they've been trying out externally. Cannot solve. If you stop, like cancer, even through operation or whatever, even you stop, able to stop cancer, right now, but then it comes back again, some people again in this life. And then, of course, the next life again, because the root of the suffering, ignorance, is not eliminated by actually the antidote, the ultimate wisdom realized, I'm the ultimate nature. So, nothing was done, nothing touched, not even heard. No idea. Your mind is far away. You see? So this teaching on there, all this, Buddha's teaching this, Panagatya's, Pandit's, all this incredible, this for you doesn't exist. For your mind, doesn't exist. It's not there, not in the world. Your mind is so far. So now this time, somehow miracle, it's an impossible thing, but it happened this time. We came into Kopan and we hear the teaching. Opportunity to hear teachings come to know. They're these. Wow. What happened to us? Can I imagine? Like having found jewel. You know, I mean, that probably not known in the world, even the jewel, wishing around jewel. That jewel probably get from ocean by universal king, bodhisattvas, or so forth. It is said in the text that Buddha's writings afterwards go back into ocean, becomes the wishing around jewel. It is said, I saw. So if you found, then of course you have so much merit. You have to have much merit to find it. You find it, you put on the top of the banner on the 15th, the Tibetan 15th of Good Day on the top of the banner. Then you pray anything needed for this life. Anything needed for this life. What do we pray? Everything gets. If Sai Baba does this, then he gives ashish or he gives watch or things going best, you see. Oh, then like that. So whatever you pray, everything happens. All the things you need for this life. Not free from, not actually part. Not liberated from the lower realm. You purify nigrama, and you don't need to liberate, you don't need to be born, Lord, not that. And you didn't, you don't need to born in samsara again, not that. And free from, even from the Lord Nirvana, can't do that. And can't achieve state of omniscience, can't do it alone, can't do that. But everything what is needed for this life, whatever you pray, it happens. It happens. You know? So, but you have to have unbelievable merit. You know, yourself, you do that, you get to get that, you unbelievable merit. You know? Like the Sai Baba, he has a merit, you know, he has a karma to the days and to give the materials other people to use, you know, so the similar that. Like we found this time by coming to Kaban, like found which grand jewel, you know, like example, you found which grand jewel in the garbage. In the garbage you throw, but you found which grand jewel. It's like that, like surprise. So, unbelievable surprise. You know, it's something impossible thing never happened. So it's like that, if you recognize. You know, more and more you check, it's like that. So surprise. Okay. Mandala prayer. Sanje jodam soje janam la jandam bada dani jaya soje sum. Sanje jodam soje jan, jandam bada dani jaya sum. At the time it didn't happen to explain the motivation. So today, the purpose of life, not just to achieve the higher birth, higher birth, you know, in perfect human birth, not just that, to not be reborn lower realms, not to be reborn lower realms again. Not just for that. Then, not just to be free from samsara, the the oceans of samsara suffering, and the cause of delusion karma, not just from that. Not just to be free from lower nirvana, lower nirvana. So beautiful state of peace for oneself. Not just be free from that, not just for that. But then the Kasuri, oh, just like as yourself have been suffering in the samsara from beginning, numberless times, the six sufferings you have been experiencing one after another, from numberless times, from beginningless rebirth. Beginningless rebirth. Again, there's danger. Again, you see, that's incredible discovery. Most important discovery, this. How long have you been suffering without time at the beginning? All that incredible discovery, incredible awakening. So then, not only that, if you don't realize the Four Noble Truths in this life, at least that, then you will have to suffer in samsara without end. And the number oceans of suffering are six realms, you'll have to experience endless, numberless times in the end, also in the future. So, in the future also, endless suffering of samsara. Ah, that's the second the most terrifying, you dare not think. Even to think that is a greatest fear of think of your future, the endless suffering something. So that just know yourself alone, just yourself, nothing. So compared, now think of other sentient beings. Why? Numberless helpings, numberless hunger gods, numberless animals, numberless human beings, numberless sura beings, and demonstrating more. Have been experiencing ocean suffering, each realm, from numberless times, from beginningless rebirth. Wow. And then, not only that, and I have to suffer again, numberless times in the future life. The ocean suffering, it's realm. Can you imagine? Again, numberless times. Wow. And that happened with Buddhama. That happened with perfect human birth. You see, you have received perfect human birth this time. Hamad with Dharma, minor teaching, and casually guide revealing the mystic path to enlightenment, virtuous friend. So the sentient beings have met, and then sentient beings who met is almost nothing compared to the rest of the sentient beings. It's nothing. So, they will be suffering endlessly again. That should be the awareness is the main concern, greatest concern you should have. The awareness. That's the most important awareness. What should I? So therefore, you see, freedom from oceans of samsara suffering, and in that brings the peerless happiness, total cessation of obscuration, completion of realization, full enlightenment, or to bring every sentient being, numberless sentient being, every sentient in that, by oneself alone. Oh, that's the evangelism. So that principle of consciousness, five similar to the, that mental factor, wishing to achieve enlightenment for sentient beings. That is the kasura. So that special, that all the, now the motivation, effort motivation, then you see, when you naturally you feel like that, then not. When you see every single thing, you feel that naturally, without a single effort. Oh, then you have a realization of bodhicitta. What that? So therefore, for that reason, I'm going to listen to teaching. So you are listening, every word is to benefit for every sentient being. You know, for example, just wanting to get some clear example, idea, to every single ant, you know, when I live in the mountain, on the ground, one spot, thousand, you know, ants. So the numberless universe, the numberless ants, you know? So just the ants, can you imagine? Wow, for the benefit of every single ant, you're listening to each word for that. It's been dedicated. So each tip, for each mosquitoes, the numberless universe, the numberless mosquitoes, no? So benefit to each every mosquito. Benefit to every maggots, every slugs, every kata. The one going like this, drinking blood. What do you call? Huh? What? Leech. Every single leech. Every single snakes. No matter how big, like mountains, or no matter how small. So everything. I'm talking just animals. Wow. Numberless. To everyone, to benefit everyone. Can you imagine? You understand? Just sending being. Think carefully. It's incredible. It's best. You know, the best. You know, listening, teaching, so the reciting one mala or mala pema hum or few times, whatever, with Janbuddha, bodhicitta. That means, you see, but many of us, like myself, many of us would may don't think. Even though we do a lot of mantras, a lot of practice, meditation, but since done with bodhicitta, one time it's done with the, it's decided to benefit every single ant that's in numberless universe. Can you imagine? Numberless chickens. To benefit everyone, you start Oman Nepema one, even one, with as long as it's done with bodhicitta, numberless universe, numberless chicken, it's done to benefit to everyone. You understand? to free them from oceans of samsara suffering, and to bring them full enlightenment. It's done to everyone. Can you imagine? You had a sad among the people. Everyone to bring them. Every single, I don't know, I don't know so many names, but every single tiny, in numberless, you see, the numberless tiny those beings, I mean, so many, not, in the, on the damn wood, there's so tiny ones, I don't know what you call, and damn wood, you know, wood is not come to drive a little bit damn.
Termite.
Huh? Termite, yes, of course termite. Termite is not announced. Termite was something very small, wow, tiny, small, I don't know what you call it. Wow, does every single to benefit. You are the son of Mani Pemu, whom, or to, that is done with bodhicitta. To every single, thing, you know, at Nepalese University, to benefit that, I don't know the name, but. Huh? Huh? Maybe. I don't know. Yeah. Is it the tiniest one? Tiny? Huh?
Woodland.
Woodland. Okay, yeah, woodland. So really, then this trying that animal, but that, you see, every single, there's numberless helpings, eight major hotels, numberless, then six neighborhood helpings, then the ordinary helpings, then numberless initiatives to benefit each one like that, to be free from ocean, something, to bring the enlightenment to yourself. Oh, Omani Pem, benefit. Every hell, the every hunger goes. Well, I don't know you, how much you can throw the suffering, but how much you heard, I don't know. Suffering, the numberless helpings, numberless universe, the numberless helpings. Not only this, within all this world. No, numberless universe. The numberless, he may be. Sura, Asura, unbelievable suffering. You see that even without listening to Dharma, you know, just all the news, you can see how much suffering, and how much you suffer when you travel different countries. So anyway, even without knowing Dharma, you know how much you suffer most of the time. And the complete suffering is only you. By studying Dharma, by knowing Dharma, you know only that. So Sura, Asura. So anyway, you see, it's incredible, it's unbelievable what bodhicitta resides on Omani Pemu. You see, for example, I'm just mentioning here, you know, when you turn prayerful, for example, you turn prayer like this, just one time, and the beams emitted from that was all the six realms sentient beings and purified them, and they all become enlightened, become generous, tells them generous again. And if you receive initiation, you can do also yourself. However, they all become generous soon. But just turn one time. You just turn one time, then you see it's a liberated number. Beams emitted from six beams emitted from six levels emitted to the sentient being. You know, purified to the because yeah. Purified the six root religions, anyways, all the old spirits, they all began chanting. Wow! So you see, turn, think that. Each time you turn, travel, just one, you know, one. Then each one you think like that, wah, 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 wah. You see, benefited to every single sentient beings, as I mentioned. Wah, wah, wah. And so, you see, whatever prayer, meditation you have done with bodhicitta, even inside one being, so you come out. So you see, ants and insects fly, butterflies or whatever insects flies, see in your room. So you see. How many times you recite Om Mani Padme Hum, or even just one, any other practice you do. So you did for them. But we don't think that. Like myself, many of us, we don't think that. We do, not lazy, even we do, but when you see insects in the house, you don't think that you benefited them, you don't think that. You know, the flies, the butterflies, you know, benefit. You did Om Mani Padme Hum, you don't think that. So it really is done. This is done with bodhicitta. So you only come out, you see goats, you see chickens, you see birds and insects. And so you see you benefited, you recited Om Mani Padme Hum even one time, it benefited to all the beings, not left even one insect. You see, you didn't say, oh, all sentient, but except the insect. You don't say that. All the sentient beings. Oh, you didn't say, oh, for all the sentient beings, except this person I don't like. All the sentient beings I don't like, in our practice, except this sentient being who angry me. Oh, except the sentient being who didn't give me a cup of tea. I'm just using example. But you see, when you tend to put it to that, you see somebody angry, so somebody who criticized you. How many enemies you have? You have 100 enemies, you have 10 enemies, you have 5 enemies, 1 enemy. It's always included, Om Mani Padme Hum, or whatever meditation prayer you do. It is included that this is prayer is done to benefit to everyone, even including your enemy. But you don't think that. But it's done, but you don't think that. I'm Om Mani Padme Hum to benefit, you know, to free from samsara, treating that person who I hate. You know, oh, he hate me, you know. Well, normally, just like I use the example myself, then you don't think that. That's the best weapon, you know, actually, than gun. Gun is no end, that killing, no end. It doesn't finish, makes more. Rise more enemy, you know, more people begin. So this best, all these problems sometimes bring them out. This is that Om Mani Padme Hum in one time. So anyway, whatever benefit to every sentient being. But we don't think that time. Like using an example myself. So we should think, but we don't think. So all sentient beings. So you see, when you come outside, you see so many sentient beings. So many sentient beings. You benefited anything with the motivation, but that you did in the prayer, in the meditation. So when you see sentient beings, yes, you did. You see, you did all those practice method to benefit them. Everyone that you see, dogs, every dog you see, flies or anything, whatever you say, you benefit. Think that. remember that, think that. See? So, like you see, whatever practice you did morning, then you go to Kathmandu. You see, from here, you go to Kathmandu. You see so many sentient people, all kinds of people, all sentient people, so many creatures, blah, 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 blah. So those goats who go in the road to be killed, and some small, big ones. So you see, you did the benefit. Or every single practice you devoted to the benefit to everybody. Everybody. Recognize. Should normally we don't think, should remember that. So you did. Yes. Yeah. So that means so happy your life. You see, made your life so many, so happy to benefit to everybody. So happy, means so much happiness in the life. Worthwhile to be happy. So otherwise, much of a time, even happiness is wrong happiness. I mean, to wrong things. Happiness by creating the karma, by killing your enemy, happiness. All things like that is the example. That's the example. So that. So. Ah. Sorry. Okay, let's see. Thank you. So the bodhicitta is incredible. You see, when you do something with resentment or whatever you do, if you do with the bodhicitta motivation generated, even you don't have realization, it's a benefit to every sentient being. Not one insect left out, tiny insect. Not one person left out. You understand? The numberless universe. Not one person left out. So that benefit, even the people who don't like you, it includes even the people who don't like you, hate you, you are doing something with the motivation, it benefits them. Recite Om Mani Padme Hum, even one mantra, it benefits to those people who don't like you. You understand? Those who don't help you, who harm you. But when you recite with the bodhicitta mantra, whatever you do, it benefits them. It doesn't do partisanship, helping some sentient, not helping some, not like that. It's every sentient. So it's fantastic. Whom you like, whom you don't like, whom you love, whom you don't love, whom you hate. Now the body, when you generate bodhicitta, and because we recite mantra or anything, benefits everybody. It's incredible. It's incredible practice. It's unbelievable. Ah, then Kasura. Jidian Guba Chinipa, Namatongava said, praised Buddha. Jidian Guba Chinipa, Te Zawa Marite. Kanshi Tome, Tedoba. Tinching Dewa Jumasung. It's very important. How much suffering? Deeds. You know how much suffering samsara deeds. the root of all that. That's, I mean, suffering is unbelievable. So, but root is ignorance, unknowing mind. You know, we talked already quite a few days. So, that not just all ignorance, all different types, but this root, you see, remember, there's the base to be labeled aggregate, and I would focus on that, I which is, mind which is focused on that, then merely labeled I. See, focus on that, merely labeled I. Then, next second, appear back. Totally opposite. Totally opposite to the reality. Totally opposite to the reality that was mirror labeled by mind. What's it mean? You know, existing from. There's something from there. That is the subtle object to be reputed according to Prasangika school, Madhyamika Prasangika school. But never came from the mind. Doesn't depend on mind labeling. Not even that. Totally exist from his side. You understand? As I explained the other day, well, I made the wrong way, so many, gross. Then they say, permanent, existing alone, independent, So all the different wrong views, the different, four different schools which even happened during Buddha's time. So all the wrong views there. In your way of your, the eye appearing, you are seeing the eye. So all those wrong views, so gross. Big part of the wrong view, die, false eye. So anyway, this ignorance, the ignorance is, you see, the subtle one is Prasangika school, the subtle object to be reputed gachatam. So, it merely labeled by mind, exists in my name, but something not completely like that. Still is labeled by mind, but if you accept label by mind, but there's something existing from it. From that. This is what Savatantrika believes. It's good. The I exists from as a label by mind, but cannot accept me label by mind because there's something from its own side. So so emptiness of the complete existence from its own side, not mind, not me label. Oh, that is the ultimate nature of the. That is the ultimate nature of the Prasangika school. Their interpretation of ultimate view. So I mentioned in the past, but also So on this hill, I did two retreats, the, you know, a small house like retreat in Tibet, or, you know, when the windows were down, windows were small down, kind of like the hermitage, you know, the German man called Dieter, he is supposed to build a stupa on the hill, and he was asked to. Then he went round the mountain, he found pieces, irons or things, then he used it in his house, to his house. But his house had several lights in his rooms, even though tiny, but it had several lights, or the difference there. I guess a little bit like we didn't have room in the old Gomba, we didn't have room like that, but they had several lights in each room. That is the difference. So I did two times there. And I think the first time he was serving me. Night time he was sleeping back outside on the hill. He didn't have tent. Then night time he moved his head, it makes noise, you know, because of the cloth, the slim back cloth makes noise. He's a very tall body, so he's a tall body, so when you go to get breakfast, when you go to get food to me, then you go on the mountain a few steps. Well, he's very tall, so few steps, reach over down there, go to get food. So then he sits outside the door. He sits half body inside, half body outside, and outside the door. Then they give us some food. Then, not in the room, but outside, he met one kind of, met one room outside, you know, the door. So then I think it didn't get a little stupa. He laid the foundation, but there's some problem, some mental problem then. I think maybe the Lama. Then he liked Bauta. He was Bauta for some years, Bauta Stupa. He was the owner. The first time we offered the light, money came from Taiwan, donation, one nun rest. We offer light around the stupa, different color stupa, also was light. For some 6 years, then broke because children hit stones or something. Then he was controlling. He was controlling the light from his room to the stupa. Some years, then I don't know. I saw one time at Dharamsala during his own teaching. Then I didn't. So anyway, one time was interesting. There's no I from the aggregates. At all, there's no I from the aggregates. At all, but there's an I on the aggregates. So strongly, I mean, uncontrollably, there's an I on the aggregates. Under the control of man. name. Under the control of name, there's eye on the aggregates. There's no eye on from the aggregates at all. But there's eye on the aggregates. With the certain his oneness, as long as truth aspect, there may be understanding, prasangya is view emptiness. But according to Kiddha Sanchan, which is not prasangya is view emptiness. So now here you can see the difference. You see? There's no aggregate, there's no eye from the aggregate at all, but there's an eye on the aggregate, uncontrollably, under the control of name. So now you see, if the eye what you see, on the aggregate, is in mere name, that's correct, prasangya. Because even though there's no name, even though there's no eye from the aggregate, but there's an eye on the aggregate, real eye, but this real eye on the aggregates. See, that's not right. Real eye on the aggregates. Oh, that's what brought to see the person can give you. Oh, you understand. Even you see on the aggregates, you have to see that it exists in mere name. So subtle. Oh, then it's correct, okay? But it's good that you don't see the eye exist. That's the same, yes. But here the difference exists on the eye. You know, real eye on the aggregates. There's real on the aggregates, uncomfortably. Oh, real eye, you see, on the... What is on the aggregate? Real eye, or that is, then it becomes a person gave. So, Samatang Dhar gave. Rangyuba, Uma Rangyuba. Uncontrollable by name. Oh, then here you can get some idea. You see? So, it's a kitchen, but. So that's because you see real eye, so then that's not person's view. So person's view exists in my name. Oh, then correct. So the cells like this. But of course, still very beneficial. It is. No eye exists from the aggregate, from the side talk. It was the same. So, because now mind is now not maintaining, so complete degenerated. So then. so kaza jiten goba jinye ba te tsawa marde. So root is ignorance also ignorance, you see, holding the eye, middle level, not that one. That is not ignorance. Then after that, existing, that subtle one, existing, there's something from my soul side. Even though you accept labeled by mind, but not, you can't accept middle level. If it's middle level, you think it doesn't exist. So, like you're falling, you think you are falling nihilism. Not true. So, something has to exist from there. So anyway, so you see, so appear, exist from that. So as I explained already two times, it's a decoration or mental fabrication, the hallucination by the negative imprint, that bright ignorance. So the mirror level I, you made it real. In a truly existent, and the existent from the soul side, existent by nature, real eye. Then not only appearing, but you know it is not true. You realize it do not exist at all, even though it appears, it's only mirage. You see mirage, but you know there's no water. Like you recognize dream is dream. It's not true. Even though appearing is not true, it's not like that. It's an appearance, you really believe it. Oh, you see, you have to know that a second mistake appear, but then on top of that, as it appears to you, you really believe it. It's true. You understand? Big mistake. A big mistake. I should have even 10 times bigger sound, but I didn't ever. So you understand? Second mistake, big mistake. Second big mistake. So should be louder sound. So anyway, you understand? Believe it is true. That is root of samsara. That is the root of samsara. You understand? Ignorance. Root of samsara is that. Believing. It's true. The belief. Just believe. Nothing concrete. Built by a factory or some company or some government. Just your own concept. Just concept. Believe. This real life is that's true. That is the root of samsara. You understand? That concept. Do you understand? But you think it's something concrete, no? That is from where the cancer comes. That's where, from where diabetes comes. That's where all the disease, whatever, I don't know, where everything comes. All the millions and billions of people, depression in the way, all of that. Suffering old age, suffering thin disease, the 404 disease, the suffering death, that's suffering pain. Then all the temporary suffering pleasure, suffering change. Then the third one, from where it comes, pervasive compound suffering. That ignorance, that concept, can you imagine? Wrong concept. All that you have to understand. So it's a very, very subtle thing. That, you see? Not believing, oh, I totally exist from not that, and believing that, not that. You see? Something very subtle. I is labeled by mind, but not really labeled by mind. It has to exist, something from this one side. Or something, you know, so subtle. It's a label by mind, but something has to exist. Oh, then concept, the mind believing that. Oh, that subtle one. Oh, the root of samsara. The root of samsara, ignorance. You understand? Oh, that's a very subtle one. You know? As labeled by mind, yes, but it exists from something. Something from its side. Subtle. Oh, believing that. Not only appearing, but believing that. You understand? Ah, the root of samsara. So, jiddhiyan gubachin nyeba te tawa marite kanshi tawa te tawa. So, kanshi tawa means by seeing emptiness only. Tongba nyi, emptiness only. So only is not translated into English. So just so many years translated into emptiness, so now people become known in different context. But not translated completely. The Tibetan translator, Dongba Nyi. Dongba is the same. Nyi only. So Nyi has a meaning, cut the ordinary emptiness. The absence of the Dongba is the absence of I, not that. Like golden elephant. So anyway, I already explained many times, so it's easy. So, not absence of I, that is nihilism. If you think emptiness as the absence of I, it's nihilism. So, while the I is existing, you see, I existing in mere name. Meaning of existence is in the dependent arising, existing in mere name. By depending on the valid, best to be labeled aggregates, and the label and base, bad dependent on those two, and the bad dependent on the label, it exists. It comes and exists. And exists in my name. So, while the eye is existing, which means my name, okay? And while the eye is existing, the eye is empty. That the eye is empty. Eye is empty of existing from its own side. You have to think like that. You have to know that. I has to be empty. While the I is existing my name. So just because saying existing means my name. So you can see that means I do not exist at all from its own side. No existence from its own side. Except me labeled by mind. You understand? So if you know what it means existing, not reality, it means existing independent arising. Dependently existing. Depend on the labeling base to be labeled, depend on those two, it exists. You understand? So existing my name. So while the art is existing, which means my name, so you can see naturally it means it's empty of existing from its own side. You understand? By hearing many existing men, you know it's the empty of existing from its own side at the same time. You understand? So I is the basis. Not true. Dembramete, tinde images. Dembramete has no true existence. No true existence. Not true. Dembramete. So that means, sir, dembramete, no true existence. So it ceases, it stops the falling nihilism. Falling nihilism. So it doesn't mean I doesn't, it means doesn't have true existence, doesn't truly exist. So stops nihilism, projects from nihilism, falling nihilism. There is no I. Then the third one, that the I is dependent arising, not tender image. The Brahma is a tender image, is dependent arising. So that protects you from eternalism. That protects you from eternalism, falling in eternalism, existing from its own side. Because it depends on the rising, depends on the vegetable label, living base. So it exists in man and dependent rising. If you see the meaning of dependent rising, then it protects you from falling in eternalism. The two nihilism, eternalism, so on. So it's a great meditation. There are so many logics to maintain emptiness, to eliminate the gakcha, the object of repetition. But this is the king, Rivija Vatendegi Tensing, the king of the logics. Tendegi Tensing, the reasoning by saying the dependent rising. So this is the main reason, king of the logic. The indicative logic, the proof, the how is it dependent rising. Just only a few words, but pop out. So profound, tremendous, to each one mentally, you see, I, children, base, and has no true existence, the mental in that. Then, reason, because it is dependent, arise. Then, mental in that. You see? Unbelievable. So powerful. So, eyes empty, in the heart of the eyes empty, that's Eliminate nihilism. So emptiness form. That is nihilism. There is no. What's that? Form is empty in the house. So then you can say, I'm empty in the side. There's no I other than emptiness. There's no emptiness other than the I. So there. There is no emptiness other than I, there is no I other than emptiness. What is it? That begins to the form. Shows the middle part, umelam, middle part, eliminating ethnicism, nihilism. So show the middle part. So that Then there were two country toys by seeing the emptiness. Emptiness only. Country toys, that obama's that ignorance, root of samsara. The ignorance, eliminated. Get eliminated. You have to understand. Get the so therefore, the Buddha taught, thinking there were two also, dependent arising, not Tibetan rice. Dependent. You know, the story is Tibetan rice. I taught in the Genesis, but now it's destroyed by earthquake, so now making new. So there, I don't know which course, there. I don't know, 5, 6, 7 years ago, I'm not sure. So I talked about 3 days, about dependent arising, because I spoke first, dependent arising. So the one old lady from England, what's her name? Old lady from England. She speaks very good English. Every language is chanting, you know, very slowly. Every single word come out. Like sentient beings or something like that. Everything is out. So. Clear, no, not that, language. So she heard, I'm talking about last 3 days, she thought I was talking about Tibetan rice. So then after 3 days, she asked her, one English monk, Namjil? She asked one English monk called Namjil, what he's talking about Tibetan rice? So Namjel said, it's not Tibetan rice, it's a dependent arising. So usually, I think at beginning of course, for more people, many people, begin the course 3 days, they don't understand what I was talking. 3 days for some, what I heard is, maybe more, I mean, but generally 3 days, they don't understand what I was talking in the before many courses. So then after 3 days, then they come to know more what I was talking. At the same time, the problem is being mentioning them fast, you know, without making clear the words. So, and then they hear something else. By seeing emptiness only, so then you see, realizing the I, example the I, you know, totally realize I do not exist. I mean, the realize that the realize totally false, appearing the realize. False. Then just a minute, then just a minute, second, to see. After that, seeing empty, seeing there's nothing to hold. Seeing there's nothing to hold. You know, like this. So we grasp the eye like this, real eye like this, all the time. Then. So, then you see false. First the I, this real I is false. Then after false, then it's a millisecond. You see, there's nothing to hold. There's nothing there. There's nothing there. Nothing to hold on to. Nothing to hold on to. There's nothing there. In reality, only that time you recognize there's nothing there. You think there's something real all the time, from beginning to end. Not only from this morning, not only from birth. But suddenly, after you saw the real life force, there's nothing to hold. There's nothing there to hold on, recognize. Nothing to hold on to. So it may appear there's no I at all. It may appear like that. But that is a sign. It has to appear like that. As if there's no I at all. No, completely no I. It has to appear. It has to appear because it shows. Because it shows. You see, there's eye on the eye. So there's eye means middle level eye. But there's eye on the eye, this is appearance. So first eye is middle level eye, made impenetrable by the mind. So second eye is the true existence. Second eye is the true existence. I exist from the eye, by nature. Truly exist, real I. So is it appearing to your mind that discovering there's an I, there's an I at all? You know, it's happiness. So that time you have to understand what that happens, because I on the I, the second I, you know, the truly existent, real I, or that is proof that that second I, truly existent, is not there. It's negate that, which is not there. In reality, which is not there. So it shows that it's not there. So then you see, it is said by Mahamudra commentary, by Jabje Hazat, by the Ketan Jamyang Molam, and that's great Bodhisattva in his Mahamudra commentary. You see. So if you don't know, the full experience of realizing emptiness from the experienced teacher, then what happens is because you don't know certain, then you think you are falling in nihilism because you have the appearance that there's no I at all, and you've been believing from beginning to birth you've been believing really. Now, you see, there's no I at all. Suddenly, incredible shock. Unbelievable shock. And the fear from deep your heart. Great fear. So the highest intelligent Bodhisattva, when they realize, incredible happiness, and the tears come out. Pores stand, hers stand upon the pores. Incredible happiness. But the lower intelligent Bodhisattva, even Bodhisattva, lower intelligent Bodhisattva, when they realize emptiness, then they get incredible fear. Oh, like that. So this, my guess is that the fear. Maybe my understanding, maybe stronger, deeper fear than meeting tiger in the road, you know? Deeper fear than that. That's my guess. So anyway, all of that. So if you don't know, Gyabje Khunda Lama Rinpoche, great Bodhisattva, from his own extensive commentary, Bodhisattva said, like child riding on horse. So a child riding on horse is on horse, but doesn't know how to ride. But a grown-up person know how to ride, then no fear. Child would have fear, doesn't know how to ride on horse, then fear. So Rinpoche said that. So. You see, it's because you know some understanding or emptiness, but you don't know the story. You don't know the full story of the full. You don't know the full experience. You don't know when you realize emptiness, what happened to the mind. So you don't know. So then this great fear comes. Then you might believe you are falling nihilism, but you are not falling in nihilism. It's because after seeing that, there's no I at all. Big shock. Because you've been believing that I really, from beginning to the world, something like that, from beginning. Start now, you see that now. So incredible shock. So, but do you see what happens at the end? Because experience that, then it leads to a dependent arising that I exist. It leads to that I exist, and mere name, It comes to that point. I exist, mere name. So that's dependent arising. So that's correct. When you come to understand, when you come to dependent arising, how do I exist, in mere name? When you come, when your conclusion, when it comes to that, is correct. And also it begins like this. It begins first, you start to see the I false. This real I, we believe from beginning it's rebirth, really exists. Now, false. Oh, when you start with that, it's correct. It is correct. You are seeing that it is not correct. If you begin with that, it is correct. But then there's other experiences in the nihilism. For example, let's say vase or mug. This is not mug. This part is not mug. This is not mug. Then you don't find mug. Switching mug. You know, every piece is not mug. So then you believe there's no other. There's nihilism. You look at the eye. You know, you look at the eye, there's an eye on the hair. You know, body and mouth, mind is not right, altogether not right. You know, with the eye, from the head down the throat. Look with the eye, there's an eye. So you fall in nihilism. Then not clear, see? Mm-hmm. That's falling nihilism. So if you fell nihilism, you believe in that. It's a negative karma, I saw in the text, negative karma is a heavy as a killer, 1 million people killed. 100 million people killed. Like that heavy negative karma. If you fell nihilism. So it depends on how you begin the meditation. You have to be careful. So you might fall nihilism. That's where you fall nihilism, when there's no clear. It's Lama Tsongkhapa explained, middle lamrim, related to the vase, as I said. So the one before, you do that. So that due to strong devotion to the guru, looking at the Buddha, no mistake, only realization, only equality. So strong devotion, then you receive blessings of guru from the devotion. All the gurus, you think that, and you receive the blessing of the guru in your heart. Then is the one strong, also maybe need an imprint planted on your mental rhythm from past lives. Received teachings or read teachings on emptiness, have read or received teachings on emptiness, or meditated in the past. So imprint, positive imprint planted on the mind, mental, you know, also so much depends on that. How much, how quickly you realize emptiness, how quickly you realize emptiness in this life depends on that. So anyway, by receiving a blessing, a strong blessing, Guru, through your devotion, looking at the Buddha, so, oh, then, you see, then happens. Even you might think, oh, this won't happen to me, or this is sort of impossible, or you might think, but, you know, when the conditions are together, strong continual purification, you are negative karma, particularly negative karma collided with the Guru in the past, and then collided extensive merits in the Guru devotion. So, when the conditions together, then mind can change. Suddenly, unexpectedly, suddenly, then you see the eye, when you just, even just very little, not recognize logic, you know, of course, you understand very little meditation, then you see the, then you may see the eye falls. Suddenly you see the falls. I mean, you're seeing that all the time, but you don't recognize this fault. It's like mirage, you sing all the time, but you believe in it's water, it's like that. So, you see, it's like that. So, then, you see, then the minister, then you see, then when you recognize that, then just a minute or a second, and then, you see, the starting is very correct, So this meditation, you see, you miss out. You miss out what you have to realize empty. What you have to see empty, use as I, the I, but not the truth in the I. You left out that one. You miss out that one. Like somebody shooting the gun. I mean, somebody shooting the enemy, you know, TV. But you're supposed to shoot on the enemy, but you miss out. You shoot your friend. Somebody who helps you. You're supposed to shoot an enemy who helps you. So like that, you missed out. You'll miss out beginning truly exit I. You left out. You left out that one. Then just the I. Or you look, or they cannot find. Then you believe that nihilism. Then you believe that nihilism. Oh, then I think I saw 100 million people killed. Same negative karma. You blame nihilism. They deny. So that's not correct meditation on emptiness. Wrong meditation on emptiness. You have to understand. So many people regard as correct. Lama Tsongkhapa said, middle Lamrim, Vaz, he explains, have to mean, it's wrong, nihilism, destroying, then there should be Cheta, falling nihilism, destroying the dependent arising, the Vaz. That. So that's Khasura. So that's what do you are meditating on emptiness? you know, there's no I. But you see, what is meditation, emptiness or nihilism? I think it's very much it depends how you begin the meditation. Very much it depends on how, is the mistake, is mistaken meditation on emptiness or correct? So much it depends on how you begin. I gave you an example of ours this year, remember? Oh, that's very important to write down. Very important to write down. Big mistake. You believe the meditation emptiness is not. Not at all. It's wrong. You're following nihilism. Isn't it? But my guru's kindness, so blessing with kindness, started. I don't know Buddha Dharma, I don't know the emptiness teaching, but that time, you know, the importance. But when they learn that one, sometimes they believe this material emptiness. So this is contrary to Rama Tsongkhapa teaching. You understand? That's all. So by seeing this emptiness, the ignorance gets eliminated. Then that's why Buddha taught dependent arising. This very important word. Very important word to know the meaning. That's what Buddha taught, dependent. So you see now why Buddha taught him. So you see at the beginning, mind focusing on the level and best of level aggregates. Mind focusing on the best of level the aggregates. Then merely input to I. Extremely subtle. What is I? It exists, but what exists is extremely, 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 extremely subtle. Oh! So, you see? Oh, that's the I, what exists! You understand? What it is? Oh, that I is a function in Mianyan. Not only exists in Mianyan, but function in Mianyan. Creating the karma in Mianyan. Creating good karma in Mianyan. Experience the result of happiness from good karma in Mianyan. Experience suffering in the result of bad karma in Mianyan. Do you understand? Oh, so now you can see emptiness. You don't find contradiction between karma and emptiness. This is so important to know. Emptiness seems don't become contradictory. You don't know what is correct. You don't know emptiness correctly, then you find a contradiction to a karma. Creating negative karma, good karma, and experience happiness, it becomes like no connection. If you understand the emptiness wrong, you understand? Then you don't find unified. You find no connection with karma. You understand? Oh, now here you can see totally connected, unified. Karma is unified with the emptiness, you know? Yeah, karma is unified with the emptiness. Otherwise karma doesn't exist. If the karma is not empty, exists from its own side. Karma doesn't exist. Karma doesn't exist. You understand? You have to, the karma, emptiness is what you understand. It has to unify with the emptiness, with the karma. Then it's correct. Creating the karma, creating the experience, suffering, experience, all that. then that's how you can be. It's how you can be free from samsara. You can achieve liberation from samsara. Ultimately, pure happiness. That's how you can cease self obscuration. You can achieve pure happiness, full enlightenment. Otherwise, So you see. So I give you an example. This from the beginning. How the eyes that. Oh, then you see the whole. All that function, the eye, the function, the karma, so everything made there. Everything made there. So, that's why. Things exist, is there. You have to always, if possible, remember, Mianam. Exist, oh, don't think real. This is Mianam. Depend on the base to label and label of mind. Okay? So existing is mere name. So see, that's a danger devotion. So the Buddha taught depend on you have to put the constant put your understanding. Dependence, how so important what the Buddha taught. That's what Buddha taught dependence. So Lama Tsongkhapa praised the Buddha. Dinjin Devachon. This is the among the many prayers, but this Lama Tsongkhapa praised Buddha taught dependence. That you see, through that, then you understand an unmistaken emptiness. Pasangika's view ended from this. So they could say, oh, unified. Oh, then eliminate root of your samsara. Eliminate. Then makes tribute free from samsara. Oceans of suffering, which continues, has no beginning. If your omniscient mind cannot see the beginning of your samsara suffering. Okay? So, beginningless, what omniscient mind sees. So that, so things in devotion soon. So because the thought depends arising, so that's how numberless sentient beings already become free from samsara. Become free from samsara, but realizing that, then person can view, and then become free of samsara, then achieve enlightenment. Number of symptoms is already, and even now happening. And so they include in that, even we who are starting to learn about it, to aware about it. Oh, Buddha's kindness. taught dependent arising, so we now we got opportunity, we due to past karma, we meet with them, Lama Tsongkhapa teaching. So you see, we have opportunity to realize and to be free from samsara, not only that, even to cease directly the obscuration, achieving enlightenment. So, maybe two words and I stop. Two words, I stop, okay? Sorry. So like this, it is said by Lama Tsongkhapa. Dumbe nana, tenre tombatang. Sherva nana, tenre sheba ni, jitain tana, jave ongbo chin, punjin la wa chu chi shin du men. To to men na te ni ta ma tang. This is a Lama Tsongkhapa praising Buddha taught the dependent arising. The person gives, particularly the person gives view, the dependent arising, subtle dependent arising. Among the revealing teachings by Buddha, the revealing the dependent arising. Revealing the dependent teaching, dependent arising. Oh, Sharanana, then they shabani. Among the wisdoms, among the they understand, among the wisdoms, then understanding the dependent arising. There's a gross and a subtle, there's talking merely subtle one. Jidentana, Jebe Omboshin, in the world, like Buddha, there was a victory. Buddha, you know, there was a victory of the obscurations, gross, subtle. I mean, the four maras, all that. There's four subtle, four gross maras, four subtle maras. So, Zalde Atundu. Yeah. Yeah, anyway, so I don't know the four subtle maras. I think maybe I've seen, I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't remember. So, I mean, the subtle imprint, you know, like that. So, in the world, like Buddha, like victory, the Buddha, and putting level church in Shinjimin. Putting level church in. So, understanding, putting understanding best. Understanding, best. Top best. It's a Buddha. It's a only Buddha who understands dependent arising. Top best. Not by others. Not by others. The other like founders of a Hindu or this and that. Not by others. You know? Buddha who is the top understanding. Then also, so that's why numberless sentient beings able to liberate from samsara, able to stop, able to eliminate the root of samsara, ignorance. You understand? Numberless sentient beings already did during now, during future, within that include us. All that because showing dependent arising. Buddha taught that because that. Then also say, so unbelievable kind. Buddha taught dependent arising. Most humble kind study. Even you offer billion, zillion, trillion dollars to diamond or wish grand jewel, fill the whole sky to Buddha, there's nothing. It is nothing. Every second you offer, it's nothing. You know, Buddha's kind is showing dependent arising, then we can realize, you know, dependent arising, the emptiness. Then you can eliminate the ignorance, root of samsara. Then, even though its continuation didn't have beginning, but we can be free from that, we can end. You understand? Do you understand? That. So Buddha, so. And then with that wisdom, directly perceiving emptiness, the dependent, then see the even subtle obscuration, then able to achieve full enlightenment. For sentient people, for numberless sentient beings, not just one sentient being, or whom you like, no. Numberless sentient beings, you understand? So Buddha's So Khan is Buddha. Wow, Khan image, Khan image, Khan image, Khan image, Khan image, Khan image, image. Okay? So here it said, by Nagarjuna, Tenjin Jawa, Jundi Jai, Sungu Zuyi, Jeba Samate, Khangi Dini Yangda, Tonga Te, Sangje Tini Bana, Chodu Tong. And from danger, Nagarjuna explained. The dependent arising is Buddha's most profound, cherished treasure of Buddha, treasure of the Buddha's holy speech. Who can see perfectly, totally pure, who see this perfectly as dependent arising, which is the emptiness, then that person, see the Buddha. Then that person able to see the Buddha, chota tongs, able to see the Buddha in the supreme state. Supreme state or highest quality. So like that. So there's benefit of the Saint Nagarjuna saying benefit of seeing the dependent. Okay, that's what I start, yeah? Today is also a very important subject. You should write down. If you're able to write down exactly, then don't throw in the garbage. Don't throw after when the course finish, when you arrive in the West or in the here. After the course finish, throw in the garbage. With the caca. Then you become something else. With all the distractions in the West. The distractions, all the rest, attachment, advertising, all the time, attachment, and object of attachment, and things like that. best advertising, object of attachment, to sell. It's okay. Oh, yeah, then stop here. So I didn't reach to this one. The other teaching what I said I will do, I didn't reach even also today. So hopefully tomorrow or day tomorrow or next day. And so what I trying to explain is not because I have realization of emptiness. It's not that at all. I received teachings from my gurus. Just a little bit of guessing, you know, something maybe. So from my gurus, you know, experienced gurus are teaching. So that's the main thing, not because I realized or not that. So I have to collect so much merit and purification to realize emptiness. So that, due to all the past, present, future merits, collected by me, three time merits, collected by number, listened to numbers, but may the bodhicitta, which is solved all the happiness, success, forms of all sentient beings, may be generated in the heart of all the six sentient beings, in the spirit, in the heart of all the sentient beings in this world, and in the heart of all the sentient, in the heart of all the students, and the benefactors of this world. Benefactors of the student, benefactors, centers, and voluntaries working for the center, and those who rely upon my promised prayer, whose name is given to me, those who are dead, living. Then all of us here, including our family members who are living and dead. Oh, that's the question. Bodhicitta to be generated without us, without delay, even second. In whose heart bodhicitta generated and may it be thought, then increase bodhicitta in all our heart. Then I forgot that. But the bodhicitta also to be generated in the body who see me, touch me, remember me, talks about me, who has my name, you know. Then who see my photos or dreams. So generated in all their heart. So that's very important. And then, then to realize emptiness. Kondi rangshin du tsam meba tang jun de ten de ruwa meba nyi pen zun ga me zho su cha wa yi lu zho kondi do wa ra chin ji. Rinyi Toba Rinpo Chi Ma Chi Epa Na Chi Chu Chi Va Nyamba Me Pa Ye Kho Ni Mbe Va Shu Khan Chi Ra Ve Kur Ve Shing Khan Chi Pen Tan De Va Ma Lu Chu Ve Ne Chen Re Si Va Ten Che Cha Su Yi Sha Pe Si De Pa Ten Chu Chi Tanya Ninja Sundu Jibela Chiji Sande Kanjin Chana Bemo Tinjin Jatso Lasa Shinde Lundro Isho. Terava Kundu Java Tsunga Vetechu Shinji Mutsu Zabi Gyāvē ngāpē ālānsā tēnyē ētāṅkē chē Dāvā mā chū chē pāntē lāmā chē kū chīn dāvā kū tāṅ kū chē chē tāṅ shīngā Cheche Senjo Sambo Chintrawa Tendra Konan Dasu Yoyjo Panjen Lame Namba Tawala Keche Tsamya Lota Miji Chinche Lepa Tome Mugu Je Lame Chen Samla Jubarayjo then the Casabone did you all that through Ramayana, the quality of Ramayana, through Ramayana, the quality of Ramayana. But listen, the minimalist Buddha may be able to consider, cherish every single sentence being more than skies of diamond, gold diamond, or the rich grand jewel. Then you see, take the life to serve them and to bring the enlightenment. Oh, the pillars happen. So that. Oh, Dane, Samde, Tamde, La, Yishin, O, Le, La, Be, Tanjo, Dube, Samba, Eta, Do, Tseba, Tsimba, Jo. Then yourself to be more beneficial to a sentient being, then we should grant jewel and we should grant tree in pure land, able to fulfill all the hopes, all the wishes, immediately. So freedom from the Lord and freedom from the samsara, freedom from the Lord Nibbana. Bring the enlightenment. Without effort. Then the culture happened that, and then due to all the three time merits collected by me, collected by numberless sentient beings, numberless Buddhas, and then a sentient being who is angry to me or devoting to me or like me or who dislike or who like me or something. So all those sentient beings who see me, who touch me, who remember me, talks about me, who hears my name, and see pictures and dreams. So that just by that, just merely by that, may they be free from all that suffering, body, mind, and to achieve all the happiness. So achieve free from oceans, sometimes suffering, and achieve the full enlightenment. So that, okay? Okay now. Dani samje tamje la yeshino la la. Mari kamar dani. Dat dani tongzu chenba rabu dani. Ti mula dungwa kunshin namba kundu data dangerous. Dani. Did all the past present future merit to collect me. Numberless sentient beings, numberless Buddhas, that which exists man in the main name. And do that matter, I who exist in the main name. Achieve the Buddhahood, which exists in the main name. lead all the sentient beings who exist in my name. To that Buddhahood, which exists in my name. By myself alone, who exists in my name. Medicine Buddha, which I asked yesterday to those people, one couple, Mangawa Chinze and Yamanta in Hong Kong, to do Medicine Buddha meditation for them. Not done yet. So it's possible to. Possible to. Huh?
I think they did in the morning.
They did in the morning?
Yesterday we did Medicine Buddha Mantra.
Huh? Medicine Buddha mantra. What about medicine? Same medicine Buddha that they name seven times. Besides, and then make prayer for them to, yeah. Huh? This one? Ah. Before you wake up? Before you wake up? What?